We've explored many dozens of worlds, if you include the moons. Those other worlds represent alternative pathways in the evolution of Earth-like planets. They are cautionary tales about what can go wrong. There's another way in which spacecraft have enhanced our appreciation of this world, and that is they have provided the first pictures of the whole Earth. And what we saw was a small, beautiful, blue and white, jewel-like world set against the velvet backdrop of space. And you look at those pictures and the thought arises that this is a fragile and vulnerable place. And if you look closely, you can see on the daylit hemisphere a kind of a corona, a kind of aura of blue. And that's just the scattering of sunlight off the atmosphere. And what is so striking about it is how thin it seems. Indeed, the thickness of the Earth's atmosphere compared to the diameter of the Earth is about the same as the thickness of the coat of shellac on a school globe compared to the diameter of the globe. There's hardly any air there. Today, there are 5.3 billion of us. Our technology has reached formidable, indeed even awesome, proportions. And today, we are fully able to make catastrophic changes in the environment that sustains us. Not only on purpose, but also inadvertently, accidentally. If we don't watch what we're doing, we can make great troubles for ourselves. The planet Venus is a clear example of the extremes to which an Earth-like planet can be taken by having too much of the greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. The surface of Venus is at a temperature of 900 degrees Fahrenheit, hotter than the hottest household oven, hot enough to melt tin and lead. The world, like the Earth, can be driven to such a disastrous, inclement climate by the greenhouse effect. To take appropriate countervailing action, we must understand science and technology. It's essential, especially the 535 members of the House of Representatives and the Senate. Something like three of them have any background in science. If a CO2 molecule or a CFC molecule is put into the atmosphere over one country, it is carried over other countries. No one nation can solve this problem. This is a global problem. These are trans-ideological, trans-national, and trans-generational issues. We are all of us, this generation and future generations, and everybody on Earth in this together. Don't sit this issue out. You have an opportunity more than most other generations to make a difference, to make a world worthy of you, of the generations of your ancestors who worked to put you here, and a world worthy of our and your children and grandchildren. The Voyager 1 and 2 spacecraft have now left the planetary part of the solar system. It's an astonishing accomplishment. Machines of the human species speeding out past the planets into the dark of interstellar space. We have accomplished that. And as Voyager 1 left the realm of the planets, we were able to get it to turn around and to photograph the solar system from which it had come. It's a portrait of where we are. The Earth is there, You have to look close. It's a dot. That blue dot is worth cherishing because it is the only home we have.